Welcome to Mailbag Monday. Let's get right at these things. First thing in describes itself as beauty tools. Yeah, that doesn't sound like something that I would order. I wonder what a Riwi is. Without looking at it, let's see if we can guess from the propaganda that they sent with it. Sour seems to be Dental 68. Huh. Okay. So that would imply something more medical than beauty. Let's see. Oh, these are micro brushes. Okay. They're tiny little applicator kind of brush things. They're good for like precision application of lubricants into odd little places and stuff like that, or putting specific bits of paint on models. And I've used them for both, and I've had these before and they were really useful. So I started to run out and figured I'd better order some more of them. 100 times dental micro brush disposable materials tooth applicators medium 2 millimeter. I got these at auction for $351 Canadian, but that auction is obviously closed right now. I will link you to this search page, which will come up with a bunch of them, and it looks like there's a bunch of them at auction right now. Anyway, there is the description of them. Non-absorbent fibers, non-linting, holds solutions in suspension, eliminates dripping, spillage, and waste. Yeah, that's where they're really useful for doing precision applications of lubricants and stuff in hard-to-reach places. And that's, like I said, the main reason that I use them, although they do work well for paint, too.
Hot lemon, by the way. You can tell by my voice that I'm not in the best of condition right now. Hopefully, by the next video, I'll be good enough to have a beer. Anyways, next thing in says cable. Says, no, solder cable. Okay. So it is solderable USB-C connectors with little circuit boards on them. It looks like, oh no, they've got 4 pins broken out on that side and 2 broken out on that side. So 6 pins total broken out. Now this looks like theta plus and minus on this side. C and V, I'm not quite sure. And the other side isn't labeled, but judging by the vias, it's probably your plus and minus voltage. So these can be used for just traditional old school USB 2, I guess, any four-way or USB, but plugged into a USB-C connection. So not the full USB-C spec, just the backwards compatible stuff, or just for power, which is what I'm most likely to use these things for. Again, slowly upgrading my collection, accumulation, whatever you want to call it, of USB-C compatible bits and pieces, because that seems to be the way of the future.
5 pieces USB 3.1 Type-C male DIY solder plug connector socket attached PCB, PC board. Got 5 of these for $1.85, which is a really good price. However, I don't think they're selling for that anymore. Got 5 of them for $1.85 Canadian and free shipping. Woohoo! They call them 3.0, but yeah, there's no way they match 3.0 spec with only 4 pins wired out. But still, that's all I wanted them for anyway. I don't want them for the advanced stuff. Not for this purpose anyways.
Next in, this is microcontroller programming module. Oh yeah. What are you? Oh, hey, it's another Raspberry Pi based chip thing. Is that an RP2040? Yeah, it seems to be. Specifically, this board calls itself an RP2040-0. Reset and boot button. Looks like a NeoPixel or something similar there. I'm going to guess that's probably more memory, just like the other board that we had. And on this side, probably a regulator, the RP2040 chip, and a resonator, I guess, frequency reference, sure. And similar to the other one, we've got a bunch of pins around the side, and then a small number of other pins just on little surface pads there, which are not the handiest, but they are available at least. So that should give you access to almost all the pins that the RP2040 can talk to. So it is essentially the same as this board, just in a slightly different form factor. This one plugs straight into USB. This one has a USB-C. And actually, the footprint is the same, except for the USB connector as well.
RP2040-0, RP2040-4 Raspberry Pi Microcontroller PICO Development Board Module Dual Core Cortex M0 Plus Processor 2MB Flash. I got this one for $4.23 Canadian. Could have had it soldered for a few pennies more, but I didn't. And at the moment, it's got $1.47 shipping on it. Although I think it was free shipping when I ordered it. Maybe not. Still, it would have been the cheapest version of this particular footprint of board that I could find at the time. Is there anything down here that we didn't already know? USB 1 host and device support, even though it's got a USB-C connector on it. 29 GPIO. 20 of them on row pins, and the rest can only be led by welding. So 20 of them around the edges, I guess that means, and the other 9 are on those little surface mount pads. And the rest of this is all standard RP2040 stuff. Very capable little chip.
So next in, it says solder paste on it. Okay, that definitely sounds like something I might have ordered. This little box has some dust on it. Hoping it's not too toxic. That's not solder paste. Oh! Is that... I think that's a block of rosin. I think. That would make sense why they're calling it solder paste, I guess. Yeah, it's kind of sticky. Sure, that's... Oh, yeah. Get a little bit humid and it gets quite sticky. Yeah. That'll be what that is. So I remember back when I ordered this, I came across a few articles, like Hackaday or Instructables or Make Magazine or something, about making DIY rosin flux. So it's literally just chunks of rosin dissolved in alcohol. So I figured, what the hell, I've got a couple of different fluxes here. Let's just experiment and play with it a little bit. If I can find those articles again, I'll put a link to them down below. And I'm sure somebody else has already made a YouTube video on it. If not, I'll definitely do it. And even if it was a while ago that somebody else did, I'll probably make that video anyway. I'm sure it's not going to be too exciting, just mixing chemistry. The interesting part, I guess, is to see how well it works or doesn't work.
15 grams, one piece, solid rosin, welding, soldering, flux, high purity, repair, durability. Paid the princely sum of $1.93 for this. Wow, if that's all it costs, I should be able to make an infinite amount of flux for super cheap. If it actually, you know, works. I don't know why it shouldn't. Rosin core solder has been a thing since forever, so why wouldn't it work? Natural resin, melting point 125°C. Oh, okay, so I could just jab my soldering iron right into it, I suppose. No corrosion and no corrosive. Okay, smooth welding surface, no deterioration and no dry. Not sure how much of that I believe, but interesting. Well, it'd be a fun experiment nonetheless.
Clean some of that dust off here and get into the last thing in, which is a box that came anonymously to my P.O. box. In case anybody wants to randomly send me stuff, there's the address. It's also in the channel description page. Anyway, since it looks like this was just sent drop shipped from someplace, probably from an eBay or AliExpress or something seller, I have no idea what it is or who it's from. Ha 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 Okay. One lifetime supply of USB-C charging cables. These are, I'm pretty sure, exactly the same brand as the ones that I got anonymously at my mailbox the last time. I don't know who sent them, but... Okay, I will never have to order a USB-C cable again. I suppose we can try out one of these cables, just for the fun of it. With no load on it. Essentially pure 5 volts. And with a 1 amp load on it, 4.7 volts. So, basically a 3.3 volt drop, give or take. And that's not perfect, but that's not bad for a USB cable, I guess. And I'm glad they're not bad because, as I said, I have a lifetime supply of them now. Thank you to my anonymous benefactor, whoever you are. And there, once again, is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. A wide variety, well, yeah, kind of a wide variety. These little brushes are good to replace the stock that I have had in the past and keep using for little projects here and there. USB solderable ends, USB-C solderable ends. I can make up a really heavy duty cable if I want to have absolutely no power loss over a distance. Put like 16 gauge wire on it or something, potentially. This little block of rosin should be an interesting experiment in homemade fluxology. And of course the RP2040 to add to my accumulation of Raspberry Pi Zero compatibles. And who can forget a near infinite supply of USB-C cables? Now I can have those scattered all around the house, in the garage, in the vehicles, just literally everywhere in the world, and still have spares until forever. Thanks to whoever sent that. And thanks to all of you for continuing to watch this madness over all the years. I do appreciate it. Questions and comments down below. Thanks also to my Patreon supporters who help me pay for the stuff that I do buy and keep the beer fridge full, and hopefully I'll be feeling like having some in a while. Thanks to the YouTube channel members who also help pay for this, and Patreon. Who else do I have to thank? Viewers like you. Talk to you later, everybody.